He's awesome. I mean, he's that guy when you meet him, like, you start talking about hard work and dedication and toughness, and his eyes light up. Like, I'm all about it. I'm in. That's what I want. And you talk to his coaches at Long Beach City College, and he was their team leader, team MVP, captain. Like, that's who this guy is. And you look on his film, what we love about him is he can play five technique. He can rush. He's physical in the run game. He's only going to get bigger. He's probably right around 255 pounds right now. One of them, like, right in that 265-pound range. So getting him here, having him go through spring ball, especially with really losing our four starters up front, is going to be huge. And I told him exactly what I expected for him when he came here about a month ago, and he has done it to the T since being here. So fired up by Shane.
With him and then his teammate, was knowing who you lost, was trying to get some more experienced guys that can maybe come in and push for playing time. Was that a big thing this year?
Oh yeah, huge thing. We're still even always working on with the influx of guys you lose that played a lot of football, not only just you quote unquote the four starters, even some backups that played a lot of football. You got to go some of the junior college route. Not something we want to do a lot of, because at Boise State we want to find freshmen that we can build up into our culture to kind of show the way. But right now you find the right guys in junior college or the right transfers like Brock Miller or some different guys we're looking at, then you can easily fit them in the mold, and it won't take them long to figure out what we're trying to do. So 100%, that was a huge deal. And found Shane, and then Divine is a defensive tackle that, I mean, he can play nose, he can play D-tackle, he's quick. He's going to be able to push, hopefully, when he comes in. He's going to come in the summertime. When he comes in, he's going to push those young guys that don't have a lot of experience, really push them to find out who kind of rises to the top.
David Moe is gone now, right?
He is, okay. Yeah. I'm trying for that seventh year, man. I saw him training down the weight room. I'm like, David, we've worked out so far, man.
I mean, it's a pretty daunting task to look at the guys you lose.
There's no doubt.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. What is it just from a coach's standpoint, yeah, trying to replace some of those guys that might have a chance at the next level?
No doubt. I mean, you look at it, it's funny because I love those guys dearly. I mean, you look at Curtis Weaver, Chase Itada, Fajoko Louie, David Moa. I mean, those are just, you're talking starters. Then those guys that even played a lot and did some different things. And those are guys I love deeply, love being around. And seeing them leave, and obviously even Kurt leaving early for the NFL, you're excited for what they do. But then you look at kind of my thing when I go up to the D-line, studs, guys that are kind of going to take the next front four, is excited for the challenge too. I mean, as a coach, telling your every clip you show is almost never a guy that's in the room right now, just because of it. Now, Scale played a lot of time, and by the end of the year he did, and he is going to be an absolute dude, and he needs to be. And I told him that, like, it's time to step into the shoes. Like, welcome. Like, you want to be the guy, like, here you go. Go mm-hmm. get it. But for the other guys in the room, like Scott, Matt, like some other guys that are working their tail off, it's exciting. Like, hey, guys, this is what you want. So if you work every single day, every rep you want, like, you can play and start at Boise State. And I'm excited to have some, because now looking at it, we lost really six guys up front four. Now, next year, we're losing none in the D-line, losing Sam Whitney at stud. But really, you're losing hardly any guys now. So having some young guys in there to cut their teeth, and really, as, I don't want to say scary as word, as nervous as it makes me with losing all that experience and guys that haven't played, it's also exciting for me to build in these guys and, like, hey, man, this is what we want to do, this is how we're going to do it, and we're going to beat guys because we're tough, we're physical, and we're technicians.
I know, you know, Brad's kind of going through the same thing on his side of the ball, but I mean, I was actually going to say, is it scary? You're saying no, but I mean, is there a little bit of uneasiness, kind of not knowing what it's going to look
like? Oh, yeah, 100%. I'm not going to sit here and be – I look at – the guys you lost and the stuff they had, I mean, it was awesome coaching those guys. But I really do, my personality, knowing these guys, like, I am really excited for them too, because I know there's talent in that room. I know there's talent in a guy that maybe hasn't played a lot. And I know every single one of those guys, for the most part, is really hungry too, because they've sat and watched the David Moas, the Curtis Weavers, and been like, dude, I want to be that guy. Well, here you go. And how do you do it? Okay, you work this hard, you do these different things, and you can get there. And it's cool to even see in the first month of us, our guys being back. All right, you say you want to be the starter. Now, what are you actually doing? Mm-hmm. You know, are you doing an extra 10 minutes every day? Are you watching extra film? Or are you just thinking, because those guys left, I'm going to naturally walk into being the guy? No, it doesn't work like that. And they know, and I've told them, like, the standard will not drop at Boise State. Like, we are here, we're going to play good defense, we're going to be physical up front. Like, that's what we're going to be. So either it's going to be you, whoever you are, or we're going to go find somebody. Yeah. That's just the way it is. And calling on those guys, and they're excited about it. But I freaking love the way those guys are working. Coach Pitt's done a phenomenal job for those guys in the weight room. And I'm excited to see stuff. Obviously, Scale and Dimitri, just talking front four, are two guys that have played a lot. So you think, you need some guys around them, but even they need to take their game to the next level. And I think they've kind of been a side note, obviously, with the guys that were up front. And now both those guys are like, hey, I'm ready. And then at DN and D tackle, it's like, hey, who's it going to be? And if you work hard and you're diligent, those guys in that room are going to be ready to go.
I think Chase, you know, Hatata was the guy that didn't really get much fanfare or attention. I mean, he's going to be a sneaky kind of tough guy to replace. What's the competition like there?
Just to talk about Chase, he doesn't get a lot of limelight. But if you watch our 2019 season, that guy makes play after play after play. Not even just talking. I mean, he had his sacks, but like just from knocking tight ends 3 yards in the backfield and being able to make a TFL, or taking two and having everybody else make. I mean, the dude barely came out of the game. I mean, I cannot tell. I mean, that guy will have a piece of my heart for as long as I freaking coach, because of the, I mean, he will be in tears on the field because of how tired and sore and in pain he is. He's like, I ain't coming out. Like, I'm a dog. That's what we are. And I say that because I have Chase, and then I talk to the other guys in the room, like, this is what we need mentality-wise. And if you don't feel you're there yet, like, you need to change and get there. Because this is what we are. This is what Boise State's built on. Like, the building you're sitting in right now was built by guys like freaking that dude. You know?
Yeah.
And you can start to see some guys like, yeah, I'm in. And some guys like, whoo, I don't know if I can do that. And so that's really been my push to those guys. But, I mean, Shane's going to have a legit shot to play early. Isaac Elamente is going to have a legit shot. Dylan Hall is a young freshman, big, tall kid that slow. Coach Pitt's done a phenomenal job putting weight on him and getting him to train to get bigger. And we have one more spot there. So I'm going to look and see, is it a graduate transfer? Is it just a couple young freshmen out there that I'm still kind of waiting on? So we're going to see what that is. And obviously, you know, at defensive end and stud, there's a lot of, you know, interchangeability going on there too. So it's exciting to see. But they, I mean, Chase did a ton for our football program, mm-hmm. and he played a ton. When you lose a guy that did that, this obviously opens a big void, but it's also a big opportunity for those young guys.
You mentioned Matlock, you know, Keegan Freeborn. Who else at those interior spots are you know, going to be looking at this spring, I guess, go from, you know, guys that maybe played a little to being contributors for you now?
Yeah, Scott Matlock has a phenomenal January. He's leading, he's pushing it. Jackson Cravens is a guy that was a transfer from Utah, had to sit last season. That's just kind of another guy, just been waiting. He's 6'2 and a half, 295, fast, explosive. He's gonna be a guy that pushes. Obviously you have scale. Keegan's done a good job trying to get his weight a little bit down so he can still, he's that physical bruiser, but still trying to be quick enough to be able to play in the movements and different, not just true run downs. And so he's done a good job. Those are obviously the guys that come right away to my Mike Callahan's done a good job. He's kind of a swing DN, D tackle. He's working on getting to that 275 range because he is athletic enough to play some DN. So, and he's physical, so he can be a little bit of a swing, kind of like Chase Hatata was early on, where he would play some D tackle depending how we were up front and DN. So those are really the guys that jump out to me as that have shown me so far that, man, these guys are really pushing the program forward.